This is Keisha here at TradeWithResolve.com, and I'd like to take a moment to create a few short tutorial videos with a new platform that I'm using with Tradestation. So I recently switched over to another broker, so I decided to go with Tradestation because I really like that they actually allow you to set conditional orders whenever you're trading stock options. So you can actually place conditional orders based on the underlying instead of the actual options price. So to me, that is an excellent feature to be able to take advantage of because the conditional order will allow you to place a stop loss order and a target exit price based on the underlying. So this is really going to automate your trade plan for you, so you no longer have to sit there in front of your platform and watch the trade unfold if you don't want to. So this is, to me, one of the best features about the platform, and that is my reason for switching to Tradestation. So I want to start out this tutorial by explaining to you a couple of different features. We're going to go over how to create desktops, workspaces, and how to set up your stock chart. So once you download the platform from the Tradestation website, this is the first screen that you will encounter. So first notice that on the left-hand side we have a tab that says Trading Apps. And if you click that tab, this is where you can add a lot of different windows to your platform. But first, let's start out by discussing desktops. So what you can do is you can right-click up here in this blue area, and then you can go to New, and then you can select Desktop. So this gives you a brand new desktop. So this is a great window to use if you have multiple monitors. So what you can do is you can add the different windows. Let's say you want a level 2, a stock chart, your positions windows, whatever you want. You can set this up and then you can drag it over to your second and third monitor. So that is the purpose of the desktop, so that you can have a different setup for each of your monitors. So you would do that under the desktop window. So that is how you can utilize the desktop feature. Next up, you can actually right-click the blue space, go to New, and then Workspace. So your workspaces are gonna be lined up here. So they're basically different tabs that you can utilize. So let's say you wanna have a certain number of windows or charts on this particular workspace. Let's say you fill this workspace, you can go back up here to the blue, right click, hover over New, and then select Workspace. And then you have another workspace here. So if you right-click the tab or the workspace here, if you go to Save Workspace, you can name the workspace whatever you wish. So this gives you even more room to have multiple windows, in a sense, to make it however you like. All right, so next up, let's go over how to actually set up a stock chart. So what you want to do is go over here to the Trading Apps tab on the left-hand side. And then you want to select Chart Analysis. All right, so by default, I already have indicators here on my chart because I actually saved the layout that I liked. So what you can do is you can go in and add your different indicators, and then you can save it so that anytime you open a new chart, all of your indicators are already there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and delete all of these indicators, and I'll be right back so that we can go over how to insert your indicators. Alright, so I have removed the indicators from the chart. So now we have a clear chart. So this is what it will look like. So what you can do to zoom in and out when it comes to the chart is you can activate the chart by clicking it, and then you can press on your keyboard the up arrow to zoom in, the down arrow to zoom out. You can move to the left by pressing the left arrow. You can move to the right by pressing the right arrow. Now, let's say you don't really like that option. Maybe you want to be able to maneuver the chart a little bit differently. What you can do is right-click on the chart, scroll down to Background Dragging, and select Enable. And this allows you to move the chart however you wish. And then you can come along the price axis here and zoom in however much you wish. So you can move it up or down, and then you can use your keyboard, press the up arrow to zoom in. So these are the different ways that you can kind of manipulate the chart to your liking so that it is the size that you wish. All right, so we are currently looking at Apple, the 5-minute chart here. So let's go ahead and add a few different indicators. So what you want to do is simply right-click your chart, and you want to scroll down to Insert Analysis Technique. All right, next up, you just look for the indicator that you are interested in. So I'm going to scroll down and see if we can find moving average. So you want to select the indicator tab. So here we have moving average one line. Let's select that and then we can click OK. So now we have a moving average on the chart. So what you want to do is right click the moving average and then select Format Moving Average. So here, this is where we can change the length. So I'm going to change this to the 50 period. Simple moving average. You can also change the color by selecting the color tab, and I'm going to make it red, and then I'm going to select OK. So now we have our 50 period simple moving average. I'm going to right click the chart again. We're going to go back to Insert Analysis Technique. I'm going to add another moving average. All right, we have this blue moving average here. I'm going to right click it, Format, and I am going to move over to Inputs. That's the tab you want to select, Inputs. I'm going to make this the 200 period moving average, and I'm going to change the color here. All right, so now we have our 50 period moving average and then our 200 period moving average. And I'm going to go back in and add a couple of more indicators. So again, right click the chart, Insert Analysis Technique. Now I want to come in and add, let's say, some Bollinger Bands. Select Bollinger Bands. OK. So now what you can do is right-click the Bollinger Band, Format Bollinger Bands, and then you can change the color. So I'm going to make the upper Bollinger Band white, the lower Bollinger Band white, and the middle Bollinger Band white as well. All right. So now we have our indicators. So we have the 50 period moving average, the 200 period, and then the three Bollinger Bands. All right, so now let's go in and add volume. We definitely need the volume indicator. So again, right click the chart, scroll down to Insert Analysis Technique, and then we're going to select volume average, click OK, and there we go. We now have our volume indicator. So far our chart looks pretty good. So we have the different indicators. Of course, if you use other indicators, you're free to go in and select those indicators, customize the chart to your liking. Now, if you wish to customize the background of your chart or the font, you can right click the chart, you can go to Format Window, and from here, you can change the background to whatever color you wish. You can change the font size or the font style. But I'm just going to leave it at default. So by default, it is on 8. So I'm fine with that. You can select OK. So now that we have our chart, if you're happy with all the indicators and everything that you have added to the chart, you can now save this. So let's go ahead and save the chart. So you will right-click the chart, and then you'll scroll down to Save Analysis Group. So let's just name this one Chart 3. So you can see here that the chart contains Bollinger Bands, two moving averages, and then the volume average. And then you want to select this box that says Automatically Insert on New Chart Analysis Window. So you want to select that, and then you can click OK. So now, whenever you go in to add another chart, it contains all of the indicators that we have saved, so you don't have to go back in and customize it later. So all of your charts from here on out will have all of your favorite indicators and your colors and customizations that you have selected. And lastly, if you want to change the ticker symbol, all you do is select the chart and then type in another ticker symbol, for example, Facebook, and then it brings up another chart here of Facebook. Let's say we want to look at Netflix, NFLX. We can now view Netflix. Now, if you want to change the time frame, all you do is, again, activate the chart, and you can come up here to interval, and then you can change the interval. Let's say we want to view the 15-minute chart. Now we are looking at the 15-minute chart of Netflix, and that is how you change the chart intervals. So that is all for this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments about the TradeStation platform, feel free to leave them below. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.